I'm joined now by Emily Austin, CEO of the Association of Apprentices. Emily, many thanks for joining us today. Yours is a very new association. What are your aims?
You're right, yes. I mean, the association was only formed last year, and last year really for us was about taking the concept of the association to bring that to market to apprentices. And apprentices told us that it was needed, but we spent those early months really getting to understand how we would deliver it. So by surveying apprentices, conducting focus groups, it really helped us shape it into the offering that was launched at the end of September. And that's our virtual community platform, our learning resources and our event. And it's been really well received both by apprentices and also employers who recognise the value of embedding it into their own apprentice offer. And that's really what 2022 is about. And our aims are to further widen that community to reach apprentices across the UK of all ages, all programmes, industries, geographies, and to deliver value for those apprentices.
The gender split is pretty much 50-50, isn't it? With more than half now being aged 25 or over. How much has that changed over the years?
I mean, the demographic has shifted. So we are seeing declines in younger groups of people starting apprenticeships, or those from disadvantaged backgrounds. But some of that shift is due to organisations realising the value of apprenticeships in helping to reskill and upskill their existing workforce to really, I suppose, fill critical skills needs both now and in the future. And also for individuals realising that actually you can change careers and you don't necessarily have to go back full time to classroom or to university to do that. And apprenticeships are a really viable route if you want to change your career path.
And the traditional role of the apprentice has changed so much too, hasn't it? Where are we likely to find apprentices these days? What sort of sectors?
In a huge variety of roles and sectors. In fact, there's over 700 different apprenticeship standards that somebody can study. I mean, data shows that skilled trade occupations still rank as the most common grouping for apprentices. And that shows the traditional nature that you just said. But actually, the next common grouping is associate, professional and technical, and the next is professional occupations. So the dial is turning slightly, and you're still likely to find apprentices in trade roles, but you're also likely to find them in nursing, for example, or legal. And that, previously perhaps may only have been accessible by going to study at university.
COVID has hampered everything for us all so much, hasn't it? How has that really affected the recruitment process, and what can be done about that now?
I mean, it did impact apprentice recruitment. So we saw delays to intakes, we saw reductions in roles, but by and large, that's pretty much recovering now. And we're seeing apprenticeship vacancies at really an all-time high. I think the bigger impact was those who were already on an apprenticeship. The Ofsted's report last year pointed to the fact that they were particularly hard hit. Many were furloughed, many were out of work, and the reported numbers of mental health cases were increasing. We're seeing signs of recovery there too, but with new ways of working and the catch-up required for work and for apprenticeships, it's causing issues or continuing to cause issues for apprentices. So it's really critical that we come together to support them, and why the work of the association is so important about connecting apprentices with their peers for advice and providing services that can support them throughout their journey.
So how optimistic are you feeling about the future now, given all that?
Oh, very, very excited.
Okay, Emily Austin, many thanks for joining us. Thank you.
Thank you.